And welcome back to another session of Pellet Tech 101. Today I want to cover a little bit on snap disks. These are also known as thermodiscs, low limit switches, high limit switches, proof of fire switches. They have a lot of different names depending on the stove make and model. Not every stove that's out there will have limit switches or snap disks. However, the majority will, and they do serve different functions inside of the stove. So today I just wanted to give a general overview on limit switches and just give you a general framework of understanding around what they are and what they do. So I have a variety here of some different limit switches. The first one here that I'm holding on to is known as a low limit switch. This is a ceramic switch, so this is a higher quality ceramic switch. Generally, you will see this type of a low limit switch mounted into the exhaust fan or the exhaust fan housing on a pellet stove. Now, a low limit switch like this is 120 degrees minus 20 F. Minus 20 Fahrenheit. So what that basically means is that as the stove heats up, once the unit reaches 120 degrees, this switch that's normally open will close, and that completes the circuit. The idea is that in some stoves that will allow the actual fuel feed to come on, start feeding pellets once the stove has sensed that it's warm enough. And then on the opposite end of things, when the stove is shut down or it runs out of fuel, once this switch goes below that 20 degree mark, it goes ahead and it shuts off the fan as a safety mechanism. So this is what we a lot of times refer to as a low limit proof of fire switch that mounts inside of the exhaust fan. Now, some limit switches have a recessed mount, like this one you see here, where it actually will seat inside of the exhaust fan housing and then bolts on. And some you will notice actually have just a flush mount, and I don't have any flush mount ones with me here today, but some are just mounted flush and will mount right up against like the back firewall or right up against the room air blower, things of that nature. But this would be, again, what we call a low limit switch or a thermodisc, and this particular one is ceramic and generally known to be a proof of fire limit switch. The next limit switch here that I have is a very common one that's used in a lot of different makes and models. This is a high limit switch. So a high limit switch like this, some of them will have what we call a manual reset button in the middle, and some of them will be an auto reset. So there's two different types of high limit switches that you'll generally see out there, the manual reset and then an auto reset. The idea for the high limit switch is that this switch is normally closed. And if the stove reaches over 250 degrees, where it no longer feels that it's in safe operation, the switch will open and it breaks the power to the auger feed motor, so it'll stop feeding fuel. And again, the idea is that a switch like this is generally going to be mounted up by kind of like the feed system area, your auger tube area. Sometimes we'll see a switch like this mounted into the back firewall. Other times we may see it near like the room air blower or our convection distribution room air fan. And the idea is, again, as a safety sensor, that if something is not quite right, that it will go ahead and will shut the auger feed off and go into kind of a cool down or a shutdown mode. Common examples would be, and again, in a lot of cases, these are mounted by the convection distribution fan. If that fan was to fail or it wasn't operating at proper RPM and the stove started to get too hot because it couldn't expel the warm air, that this limit switch would open or trip and it would go ahead and shut down the fuel feed. Now, on one like this where you have the manual reset, once the stove is cool and I've assessed the problem, I can then go ahead and push the little red button to reset the switch. Now, other high limit switches will not have this manual reset switch, and essentially with those switches, once they cool down past the secondary number that's listed, the switch auto resets. So for an example, this switch right here is a 200 degree Fahrenheit limit switch. Most high limits will be at least 200 degrees Fahrenheit, some will be 250, so there's some variance within there. But generally the second number is around minus 20 F, minus 30 F. So with any limit switches where it's an auto reset, Once it goes below that secondary number, the switch has automatically reset itself. It is important that if you're having issues with a safety switch tripping, especially with a high limit, that you're inspecting those areas that could potentially be a problem. There is always the factor that the limit switch itself is just getting faulty, old. Generally speaking, limit switches like this can last anywhere between 3 seasons and 8 seasons. So it kind of varies, but over time these do need to be replaced. However, you always want to take a look at any other elements that may be causing a limit switch to trip. In other areas, the other most common area that this will be mounted is either in the back firewall or up by the actual auger feed shaft. So a common example there would be if I've been neglecting the maintenance and the cleaning on my stove, where I have heavy ash buildup that's maybe in the heat exchangers, the back firewall, the firebox, the exhaust manifold where the stove it can't breathe as it needs to breathe as far as with combustion air. And let's say maybe my fire pot has gotten dirty and pellets are starting to fill up and I have a big lazy wild flame that's inside the stove. Maybe that flame starts to shoot up the auger chute. That, again, this switch is located in that area, and if it reaches over that kind of that max safety temperature, that switch will trip and it will shut down the auger feed to the unit. So safety switches are there for a reason, for safety. And again, it is important that if we do have an issue with a safety switch, that we are able to take a look at anything and everything that may have caused this limit switch to trip. Same as the other one, this particular one is a recessed mount, so this one would seat inside of a hole, whether that's on the room fan, or whether that's on the back firewall, or whether it's on the auger shaft. So some are recessed and some are flush mount. The last limit switch I'm going to show you here, this one is from Quadrifier, or HHT. And this is used in a number of different models from Heatilator and Quadrifier. I even think that this did some heat and glow gas stove models as well. This is also a high limit switch, but this one, as you can see, does not have that manual reset. So essentially, if this was to reach maximum temperature and shut off the fuel feed, the stove will go ahead and shut itself down, and then the switch will reset itself. So on any limit switches, you're gonna find a series of numbers, and you have to look closely. Some may need a magnifying glass to see, but this particular limit switch reads L200F-40. So essentially what that means is that, again, this particular style limit switch is normally closed. If it reaches 200 degrees Fahrenheit, this switch is going to open, shutting down the feed or the auger feed to the system. And then once this switch goes below 40 degrees is when it does its auto reset. So that's how this particular limit switch works. If you have particular questions regarding limit switches, safety switches, thermodiscs in your stove and what they do, or if you do tend to need a replacement for one of your limit switches, we're always happy to help. We guarantee the best prices on limit switches and have just about every limit switch for every stove that's ever been made. So hopefully that was kind of a helpful tutorial. One last limit switch I'll mention is a low limit switch that's generally used to turn on the blower. So there's a lot of stoves where that room air fan or your convection distribution blower doesn't turn on until the stove gets hot enough. And in most stoves, there will be a limit switch that's sensing that temperature. So once it reaches 120 degrees or maybe it's 145 degrees for your particular stove, then that room air blower will turn on. So when somebody maybe is having an issue where the room air blower isn't turning on, a lot of times we like to take an inspection or a look over at the limit switch or the safety snap discs, the thermo discs that are in the stove, in particular the one that controls the blower. So again, every stove make and model is a little different, how it operates, how it functions. That's kind of what sets us apart, is that we've been doing this for almost 30 years now, and we are recognized as the largest in the country, and we have one of the most expansive tech support teams in the country. So whether you purchase your stove from us or not, we are happy to help make sure that your stove is running at optimal performance, and you're warm and happy and safe. Thanks so much for tuning in to Pellet Tech 101, and I'll see you for the next video.